One of the more interesting details in this project is this staircase. What looks simple at first glance is actually quite complicated. And today I wanna walk you through some of the details that will be involved in building this staircase, because we're gonna do it all here on site at our 45 White Oak project. What you see behind me is actually a construction staircase, meaning that this is temporary. This staircase will be removed and we're actually gonna replace the entire structure with all LVL stringers. So this right here is just a traditional KD 2x12 cut into a stair stringer. We're gonna replace this with LVL. It's stiffer and it's stronger. We're gonna do them every 12 inches on center to give stiff support. One of the other things that we add to all of our stringers is actually a 2x4. So not on this side, but on this side, we're gonna actually add a 2x4 on the stringer, which gives you some extra rigidity, which is gonna prevent any of the bounce. This whole staircase has to be self-supporting. There's no wall in the middle, there's no post like it has right now. So you want that staircase to be really stiff. One of the things I realized early on in my career is that when you walk up these staircases, you get this hollow sound. So what we'll do is actually fill all of the cavities with a rock wool, mineral wool bat insulation, helps prevent some of that hollow sound. After that, we're gonna be installing our plywood tread as well as our plywood riser. And then on top of that, we're working with Madera, and Madera actually fabricated all of the stair treads for us, and they're all pre-finished. You can actually see it in the rendering, but you'll see how the treads actually hit our plaster wall. And that plaster wall is continuous all the way up, and we'll get to the skylight here in a minute. But the downside of doing that is that you don't have a skirt on the wall here. And when you have a skirt on the wall, you have a nice spot where that tread can come over and be butt to it. And sometimes you can even have a mechanical fastening between the two materials. Where this tread is gonna hit plaster, it's gonna be really difficult, not only to get a tight joint, but for that joint to stay tight over seasonal change, especially here in Massachusetts where you get cold and heat. So what we've actually detailed is the treads will stop about an eighth of an inch short, and they'll actually be a piece of rubber, black rubber, to give you a really nice intentional shadow gap all the way up. Just an eighth of an inch gives you a little deflection, and it gives you this nice consistent gap between dissimilar materials, which is that white oak tread and that plaster. I want to talk about the complicated part of this project though, this handrail. So this handrail is essentially a plaster wall, and what that looks like is right here. So the plaster wall goes across the top and then comes down and then loops back. This section right here where it has this really tight radius is very, very complicated to build and to execute in place. And that's all plaster. So what you're looking at is essentially we're gonna be building a solid plywood wall. It'd be two layers of Advantech, bolted, glued, screwed together with a half round on top, and then it will get coated with a plaster. Speaking of plaster, all the plaster in this space is unpainted. Now, a lot of you guys that aren't in New England might say, of course it's not, it's plaster. We don't drywall in Massachusetts. We've talked about it a million times. We just don't do it. We always plaster and we typically paint it. Here, we're doing a natural plaster which will be troweled and have a natural look to it. That handrail is all plaster. And I say handrail, but what I'm getting at is that's really the guardrail or the wall of the staircase that loops back down. And all of this section that has that scoop has to be done by hand. We're gonna be working with Colby from Trowel Inc. And they're gonna be building a lot of that by hand with jigs and essentially a guide that will give that consistency from our flat section all the way up. But the complicated part, if you come over here on the drawings, you'll actually see this right here is our plaster wall that I was showing you. So if I'm looking at my rendering, this section here is the plaster, which is this. And then you'll see right on the other side is this white oak handrail. And this right here is the profile. So you have your plaster, and then you have this radius, and this is all white oak, and then it comes down here, and that's white oak all the way down to what will be the stair treads and risers. You can see how complicated that is to do as a straight section, never mind coming down and having this really nice curve that comes down and then essentially rolls all the way down to that first tread. So this is gonna take a lot of really specialized carpentry and a lot of time and detail. And our crew is gonna have to work very carefully between the trades, between plaster and between essentially millwork. You can see right here what I was talking about, the double plywood wall. You have the double plywood wall bolted. And then you'll, if you look closely, you'll actually see that we have this uplight. And what that uplight is right at this wall. You have this plaster wall coming down, and at the very bottom of it, we'll have this LED tape light, very similar to what we put under cabinets or in a shower niche and things like that. But it will sit completely flush with our hardwood floor, and then it will uplight the plaster. It's a very subtle detail, but something that's going to add a lot of mood to this whole section. And being that this is a raw plaster, you're going to get a lot of movement in it. So as light sheds across it, you're going to see a lot of that movement, which is just going to accentuate the beauty of that plaster. The plan view here, the tight radiuses, and then this, how this goes up. And similar to the bottom here, the top actually rolls and then lands on that second floor. Before we go up to the second floor, I want to talk about basement stairs. So as you loop around this wall, this goes down to your basement. Your basement is not an unfinished space. That's actually your main point of entry if you live here. You're coming out of your three-car garage into a beautiful mudroom, and then you have the staircase coming up. The one thing that we did here is we simplified it just a little bit. We still have the same treads and risers. We still have the same tread detail to plaster wall detail, where you have that really nice eighth inch intentional gap. But we don't have any curving, which was by design. We wanted to save that for the main staircase and keep this one a little bit more simple. However, one of the nice things we are doing is that when we'll have our permanent handrail in, we'll be installing all of our standoffs inside the wall. So we'll actually attach it directly to blocking, and then when we blue board and plaster that, all you'll have is a stainless steel rod coming out, which you actually can see on the drawing over here. Your stainless steel rod comes out and captures your handrail, and you don't have that escutcheon on the wall. You know, that discussion just, it really isn't a detail that anyone wants to look at. It's a pain in the butt to put those screws in. And it's just a nice finished detail that right now takes a little extra work on the front end, but overall just ends up with a much, much better product. Upstairs is where, you know, we're bringing in all of the natural light. I shouldn't say that. We have these two beautiful, we have a lift slide on one side and this massive window on the other side. But we have this 9-foot by 9-foot skylight that really is shining all of the natural light onto this staircase. And what we wanted to do is we wanted to really detail what that looked like in terms of how it terminated to our plaster walls and how it terminated into the second floor. So you can kind of start to see a peak of it where the plaster wall stops and you have this datum line. On all four sides of the skylight, we're actually going to be installing the Peterson cover brick, which is the material that we're using on the outside of this home. On the four walls, we have three different conditions. This wall is vertical. So as we're installing that brick tile up, it's just like we're doing it on the outside. We have our horizontal strapping, and then we'll go all the way up to our glass. We have a small reveal at the very top. We'll actually be installing strip lighting there as well. So we'll be able to kind of make that skylight glow at night. But you're gonna get a James Turrell look where there's no frame, there's just glass. And frankly, as you look right now, even though it's gloomy out, it doesn't even look like there's glass there. It's completely transparent. So the wall across from me and the wall above me are angled and they're beyond vertical. So as we're hanging that tile, it's gonna be a little bit more difficult to hang that tile because we're gonna have to consider them falling. This angle works out where the tile itself will actually be almost vertical, because otherwise they would sit on an angle on a vertical wall. Hopefully that makes sense. But we'll be able to install them on horizontal strapping all the way up. Now the difficult one is over here. This is way beyond vertical. So we're essentially hanging these tiles upside down. So not only are we gonna be anchoring them in horizontal strapping, but we need to prevent the bottom edge from essentially curling out and essentially falling down. So that's something that we are working through a detail. Essentially we'll have a clip on the backside of that shingle to allow us to clip onto the previous course, allowing us to not only support the top edge with screws, but have a clip that grabs the bottom of the shingle and holds it to the lower section. Because it really creates this big area of the skylight pulling down and having this material that essentially connects you to the exterior. You're gonna have the view over here to the exterior walls, and also gives you that nice datum line where you have the flat ceiling across, which is plaster, and that line comes straight across, and you're getting these really straight, continuous lines, which is gonna be a big deal from an architectural standpoint in the final condition. The one thing I do wanna point out is you'll see some ductwork that's kind of hanging behind these walls. We've actually designed this area because we knew that this was gonna be essentially a heat sink. All the heat would go up here and get trapped. We have multiple returns that are gonna be installed behind our shingles. We will pull return air through the shingle gaps. The shingles are not tight. There's actually quite a bit of undulation when they're installed, and we'll just allow the return air to pull through those, so you actually won't see any return grills, but it will allow us to capture the heat that gets trapped in here and bring it back through and condition that space. And then as we're looking at it, you can kind of see what that looks like as I'm looking up. So this is looking at the vertical wall, and you can see how you have no skylight frame there. You're just seeing sky, and really has this beautiful datum line and look into the skylight. What a great way to walk into this house, the single family development we're building here in Wellesley. If you're interested in building with us, click the link below, schedule a 15-minute consult, and we can talk about your project.